Ronaldo and I decided to take this Cessna 172 from Cocoa Beach, Florida to see the Pacific Ocean and back, all for the fun and adventure of doing it. In part one, we started the trip off with a low approach over the Space Shuttle landing facility at Cape Canaveral. Then we landed on Merritt Island and we collected water from the Atlantic Ocean on Cocoa Beach, Florida, which we plan to take with us and dump into the Pacific Ocean and officially make it a coast-to-coast trip. In part two, we left the southeastern United States behind us by covering 1,100 miles in one day, ending up in West Texas at San Angelo Mathis Field. San Angelo, Texas is where we start part three of this coast-to-coast trip, and today we catch our first glimpse of rising terrain as we tread into the threshold of the American West. We know there's a giant frontal system heading east across our path. In a Cessna 172, we certainly do not want to deal with IMC, icing, and mountains all at the same time. Alamogordo, New Mexico is a good place for us to tie the airplane down at the end of this day and let the front pass over us for the next couple of days. We have a bit of an issue though. The big runway 422 at Alamogordo is just known closed, as well as taxiway Alpha. I called the FBO and asked if we can still land on the dirt runway, which is much smaller, and still taxi to the ramp, and he said no, we won't be able to get to the ramp. So basically, the airport is useless. The NOTAM does say the runway will be opened at 5 p.m. local time, so our best option is just to get as close as possible, then head towards Alamogordo when it's close to time for the runway to open. So given that we have time to kill and we both like Mexican food, what better stop do we have than the West Texas city of El Paso?
From 30,000 feet above the desert floor, I see it there below. A city with a legend, the West Texas city of El Paso.
El Paso Tower Skyhawk, 9337 Hotel, visual 26 right.
That's 37 Hotel, you can change to runway 26 left. Runway 26 left, clear to land.
Okay, we'll sidestep to 26 left, clear to land, 26 left, 9337 Hotel.
3962.
Okay, George. Autopilot off. Relanding checklist. Brakes pedal test.
Brakes test.
Landing light on.
Landing lights on.
Autopilot off.
Autopilot is off.
Seatbelt shoulder harnesses.
Runway's made, going to idle.
Positive ground contact. El Paso ground, Skyhawk, 9337 Hotel, clear, 26 left, Victor going to Atlantic.
Track 9337 Hotel, El Paso ground, taxi park via Victor.
Parking via Victor, 37 Hotel. Alright, easy peasy. Atlantic's right up there.
Mexican food in El Paso, good little place. We're gonna head back to Atlantic. Probably do a little flight planning, maybe look at some stuff in Alamogordo, like rental cars and whatnot, and then I'm gonna call the FBO. I wanna get them to confirm that the runway will be opened up at 5, as the NOTAM says. Because if we fly all the way up there and the runway's not open, you know, it's still got X's on it or whatever, we're gonna have to turn around and come back to El Paso in the dark, which don't exactly want to do. So if all works out, we'll be able to get into Alamogordo time, but we're just gonna have to play it by ear, see what it does.
El Paso International Airport, a disinformation call. 22510. Wind 150 at 5. Visibility 10. 7,000 scattered, ceiling 9,000 broken, 2,000 overcast, temperature 16, 2.3, altimeter 3010, remarks, brakes in overcast, expect visual approach runway 26 left.
9337 Hotel, type Cessna 172 Skyhawk over here at Atlantic. We'd like to be VFR to the north, going up to Alamogordo, going to do the VFR corridor between the restricteds, and we have information golf.
Sky 37 Hotel, roger, requesting flight following with Holloman approach.
Affirm. Okay, flight following.
Sky 37 Hotel, departure frequency 119.15, squawk 4264.
Departure frequency 119.15, squawk 4264, Skyhawk 37 Hotel. El Paso ground, Skyhawk 9337 Hotel.
Skyhawk, Niner 337 Hotel, Paso ground, safe parking.
Atlantic, information golf.
Skyhawk 37 Hotel, runway 26 left, taxi via Lima, verify your requested altitude.
We'll go out at, we'll start out at 5,500 for 37 Hotel, we'll taxi to 26 left, Lima. El Paso Tower, Skyhawk, Niner 337 Hotel, 26 left, Lima, ready for VFR departure.
Skyhawk 7, correction, Niner 337 Hotel, Paso Hotel, short runway 26 left, traffic line.
Hold short, 26 left, 37 Hotel.
.com 4084, contact departure, have a good day.
Departure.com 4084.
Southwest 302, turn left, taxiway Kilo, taxi to park this frequency, have a good day.
Kilo to park with you, Southwest 302, enjoy, thanks.
Skyhawk Niner 337 Hotel, turn right on course, runway 26 left, clear for takeoff, wind 150 at 4.
Right on course, 26 left, clear for takeoff, 9337 Hotel. That's a freaky sight, isn't it?
It is. 26 left. 26 and 26.
See how slowly we're accelerating?
Uh-huh.
So we got plenty of runway. We don't want to rush it. We just want to wait till the airplane tells us that she's light and ready to fly.
Medevac Native 30, Paso Tower. Traffic departing runway 26 left, regional jet southwestbound.
And we just pitch for a climb and right turn whenever you feel good about it. A little bit different feel, right?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. I'm comfortable.
37 Hotel, speed and altitude permitting, start your right turn out.
We're starting the turn now, 37 Hotel.
Correction, SkyWest 2992 El Paso Tower, fly the Atkin 5, departure runway 26 left, clear for takeoff, wind 1405.
Atkin 5, departure 26 left, clear for takeoff, SkyWest 2992.
El Paso Departure, Skyhawk, Niner 337 Hotel, climbing through 5,000 VFR on course.
Back Niner 337 Hotel, El Paso Departure, radar contact.
We are on our way.
Back Niner 30, contact tower 118.3.
That is a little bit different sight picture on takeoff than you're used to, right? A big rock wall right there.
It is.
That is really cool, the sun is lighting up the mountains up there.
Uh-huh.
Like that's Alamogordo.
Alright, you got eyes outside.
Eyes outside.
Take a couple of pictures here. Might have to swap lenses. We'll see.
Back 37 Hotel, traffic 12 o'clock, 18 miles, altitude indicates 4,900 southbound.
Looking for the traffic native contact, 37 Hotel.
I can zoom in on it.
Back 37 Hotel, traffic no factor.
Yeah, we just got that inside. That was a Black Hawk, Roger, 37 Hotel.
Thank you.
I'll tell you what, if we're going to get there and we're going to be ahead of schedule, you want to just go ahead and climb up?
Yeah.
That'll put us about even with the top of the mountains. That way we can get some good views and good shots.
Okay.
For the mountains. Let me let them know. Element approach, Skyhawk, Niner 337 Hotel.
Skyhawk, 9337 Hotel, home approach on altimeter 3011.
3011, we're passing 6,200 up to 9,500 VFR.
37 Hotel, copy all, sir.
At 37 Hotel, once we get up to the Alamogordo area, we're going to do a little bit of maneuvering on the front range of the Sacramento Mountains and then go into Alamogordo for a full stop.
Scott, 37 Hotel, copy all, sir, and just let us know whenever you're ready to go direct to Alamogordo.
We'll go, 37 Hotel. Alright, how are we doing on time? 4:32 currently. 2332 Zulu, it opens at 2359. So the restricted kind of keeps going here, and then it cuts off at a certain point right
yep.
here. So once we get past that, if you want,
just play.
We can just whoop, go to the mountains
yep.
and just fly right by the ridge and do whatever we want. Just mind
from
Holland's
here,
Delta.
I'm going to do that and navigate because a straight shot will keep us clear. Keep us clear of that edge there.
Right. We could actually go up there if you want, and then dump down through the valley. The valley's right there, or the canyon.
Okay.
Just as soon as we clear that restricted.
You should have figured out by now that as long as it's safe, unless you're telling me to do something unsafe,
right.
Let's go do it.
And the wind is pretty much calm, so it's not. I don't think we're going to get too much chop coming through there.
Yeah.
So check this out. Right off to the right, up here, that little white thing sticking up, that's an observatory.
Well, we got a truck.
You can't really beat this lighting. I think this was timed perfectly.
Yeah.
And I like that we have a few extra minutes. So you see the runway down there?
Yes.
Big runway. So here's what I would do. I would kind of aim ourselves towards the airport right now, and then I would make a left turn and enter back into this canyon and start our descent, and then kind of go around that horseshoe that we just flew up and start descending, and then when it spits us out, we'll be close to a final for 2-2, or like a base, kind of. You see what I mean?
So you want to aim towards the airport and then make a left turn?
Go this way a little bit, and then
yeah,
left,
okay.
Left turn.
And just hook it back around.
Right, and then kind of go the opposite way that we just went. And descend, and then this deep canyon right here, it'll spit us out right on a base.
Look at this.
That's so cool. It's really kind of freaky the first time you do it, but it's really cool when you descend below the rim of the canyon, and then you kind of follow the canyon below the rim on either sides of you. And the good thing is we're descending, we're not trying to outclimb it, so we don't really have to worry about a performance issue. And the direction that we're going, the canyon is descending away from us. So if we have any issues,
we're getting better, not worse.
It's getting better, not worse. Precisely. So yeah, right where those cliffs are, we just come right in. Helaman 37 Hotel, we're going to continue this left turn to enter the pattern for Alamogordo. We'd like to go ahead and cancel flight following.
Skyhawk 37 Hotel, copy all, sir. First service terms, squawk VFR. Change to advisory frequency approved. You have a great evening.
VFR going to advisor. We appreciate all your help. 37 Hotel, good night. Okay, and comp 2.
Board. Automated weather observation.
Catch the winds
two,
one more
three,
time. See
five,
how it comes
five,
up, and then it's going to slow down again.
Wind 150 at 8 knots. Visibility more than 10. Sky condition 9,000 feet. Scattered. Temperature 14 Celsius. 2.3 Celsius. Altimeter 3011 inches of mercury. Remarks.
Runway 2204 and taxiway Alpha are closed until 1700 local.
Alright, it opens in 3 minutes.
We will not be there by then.
Yeah, and we still want to do a low approach. Just take a look at it. I think I saw a truck with amber strobe lights sitting next to the runway. I don't know what that is. And then this is where we make our turn. You see where the trough starts and goes down? That's where we just make our turn, and we can just descend below the rim and continue the descent down. And it's like it looks wicked. And we've got everything done. We'll go ahead and call the descent checklist and the pre-landing checklist complete, except for your carb heat whenever you're ready.
Yeah, I'm going to wait because, I'm well above
right.
2200. But I do want to watch my cooling, though.
Sure.
This is freaking amazing.
It's a little different, man, isn't it? And then you see where it dumps out to the valley?
Uh-huh.
There you go. You still get a little bit of chop in the mountains, but it's not bad right now. I've had it much, much worse coming down through here.
Yeah, we're going down 1,500 feet a minute.
Alright, that's 1,000 above pattern altitude. You could probably start to shallow up the descent now and start slowing it. And you're doing good on your shock cool warning. 26. Well. You catch a glimpse out the window and you're like, oh crap, the ground's like right there.
Uh-huh.
Got a tower right there. Alamogordo traffic, Skyhawk, left base runway 22, Alamogordo. Alamogordo, Skyhawk, final 22, going to do a low approach, make left traffic, full stop 22, Alamogordo. We're just making sure there's no cones or barriers or anything in the middle of the runway. They got the reels on and it's lit up, so, and the ATIS said, or the AWAS said, remarks opening at 1700 local, which we just passed, and the airport manager himself told me. They're opening it at 5 o'clock.
Okay, landing lights on. Car heat's coming. On.
Make sure I'm going to leave out a little bit. Fuel on both flaps is required.
The threshold, yeah. Fuel on both.
And whenever you get a chance, just check your brakes. Make sure you got good pressure.
I got good pressure.
All right, pre-landing checklist complete.
1500. And slow her down.
Alamogordo traffic, Cessna turning left base runway 22. It'll be a full stop. Alamogordo. Your final looks clear. I don't see any other humans. Except ground dwellers. Alamogordo, Cessna Skyhawk turning final 22. Full stop, Alamogordo.
Oh yeah. Feel that crosswind.
Oh yeah, it's pushing us, isn't it?
Yeah. Alright, 15 degree flap. I'm going to come in at 65 over the numbers and just let her float.
All right, yeah, we got 9,000 feet to float.
Come on!
That'll do. Alamogordo, Skyhawk, clear of the runway, Alamogordo.
Airplane's right. Clean.
After landing checklist complete. Found it.
Nice.
That was awesome. That was an awesome flight. Alright, I think Alamogordo is going to be a good place to get stuck for a few days.
This is all they had to rent to us, a Ford F-250. It's a little pricey, but we were like, well, we need a car, so.
It's the only car they had.
It's the only one they had,
well,
so.
They had a, what was it, a 16-passenger van?
Yeah, 16-passenger van, and we were like, no, well, we'll take the pickup truck. Honest to God testimony of what we just did. What do you think?
That was the most amazing flight I've taken since I got my pilot's license.
Airplane, Sacramento Mountains in the background. That's what we just flew around. Oh, that was so cool. I haven't done that in a few years and it was in a different airplane, but yeah, that was amazing.
It just happened to be here at the right time too, with the sun going down.
We hit golden hour. We couldn't have hit golden hour more perfectly. And just the pics, like I cannot wait to go through the pictures on my phone that I took and all of the beautiful 4K footage that I got with this camera. That's gonna be awesome. But we zipped around the canyon up there above the mountains, and then we kind of made a U-turn, went back into the canyon, and then you started the descent and just came right down the canyon there. And when we broke out of the canyon, we were on a left base.
Left base.
That was absolutely, absolutely phenomenal. And that's why I wanted to make it to this airport today. Plus there's some cool things to do in Alamogordo tomorrow. Starting tomorrow, the weather is gonna get nasty. We're going to stay here and we're going to continue our trek probably Saturday morning is when the weather is supposed to get good. I don't know. We'll see what the weather's doing tomorrow. If it's nasty and rainy, white sands probably won't work. Because then we don't, well, it's a 4x4.
Yeah. We can just go to the museum too.
Yeah. There's a space museum up on the side of the mountain up there too that I want us to go to. And then there's other stuff to do. So we're going to find some stuff to do in Cloudcroft. And this is by far my favorite day of flying.
It is.
On this trip so far, and this is day two. Day two is my favorite, this is my favorite flight of the entire trip so far. Last night being my least favorite.
Yeah.
That wasn't too fun. IFR holds, soup approaches, at night, not fun. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and leave the video off here. Call it a day, leave the airplane here at Alamogordo, and probably find food in a hotel. And anyways, you have anything else, Dad? Anything at all
good.
Whatsoever?
Let's go look at the pictures and the video.
I know, right? Let's go look at the footage and the pictures. If you like the video, definitely hit thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't yet, definitely hit subscribe. I would appreciate it. Don't forget about aviation101.com. You can head over there, get t-shirts, hats, the little knee pad, the kneeboard pad that I was actually using all day long. This is a cool place. We're going to call it a day. Go look at the footage and pictures. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay current, and stay proficient. And we'll see you on the next part of this series, which is going to be day three. Is that? This was day two.
Three or day four.
Two. I'm going to decide how to number them later. We'll see you on the next one.